Hi-o, everybody. This is the Epic Fudge, ready for the next part of the Star Fox 64 playthrough. In this part, we shall be tackling Zonus, a pristine vacation spot in this, in the Lilac system. Although, for some reason, it's green. Let's see what that's all about.
There's an enemy base there!
Oh, God.
Affirmative, General.
Seriously, what kind of general gets so shocked at an enemy base being on a dead planet? Christ. I'll let the text guy go over the whole thing about Zonus.
Let's sneak in low and surprise them. This is Zonus? I can't believe they're kids.
What a dog!
I hear you, Flippy.
Watch out for the searchlight!
Let's take them all out!
Slippy got dumbfounded by birds there. Yeah. Such a brilliant pilot. That was a lucky shot. I'm not really too sure I want to do that. I'd rather not die and leave an ETA alone on the sun. It's kind of a bad idea.
We're closing in on them, Falco.
And this, my friends, is Cat Monroe. I'll get the tech guy to do a bio on it.
Take the right part, boy. I have the left.
Cat, what are you doing here?
Is that any way to greet a girl?
That's a pretty good point. Anyway, I'll go over the little gimmick with this level. This level has you shooting searchlights. It's sort of kind of a stealth element, but really it's just your ability to be able to shoot things. In this case, you're shooting searchlights, which give you 3 points each. 4 points if you hit it with a splash shot or a charge shot, which is why I'm aiming unaimed charge shots right now. Slippy's just flying around aimlessly. I really don't know how he's not being caught by these searchlights. I have to do a bit of editing here with the music for this little bit.
I've got somebody on my tail!
Oh, goody! She's just as bad as the rest of them, only she's invincible.
Beautiful! I could kiss you for that!
Ugh, something out. You're a cat.
Aim for the runner box!
That's actually quite useful information. I never usually think to do that, but shooting those rudders helps you to get the stuff behind those gates, one of which is a searchlight. But to be fair, you can just abuse the charge shot glitch, which I do here. Sorry.
Location confirmed. Sending provide.
I do find it quite cool that there's a massive system for this game.
Enemy tanker!
And this is where it starts getting fun. Very hectic.
You've got an enemy on your
tail! Everything past this part now is the reason why I love this level so much. This is one of the most hectic levels in the game. It's not exactly hard to do, but it is very hectic. And because it came straight after such a slow level like Aquas, I don't know why, but the island feels really, really quick in this level.
Here I go!
Again, probably because I compared it to the Aquas level. The marine. But yeah, your island feels really agile in this level. As a result, you fly around. And I tend to be quite rough with the island in this level. It's not so bad, there's plenty of stuff here to stop you from dying. The biggest hazard here is you're losing your wing, which I'm really surprised that one's done already. Yeah, the amount of crap that's chucked at you in this level is brilliant. I'm crashing into a lot of stuff there. I'm really surprised I haven't locked the
these guys don't quit!
Oh, God damn it, Falco. Yeah, I get a pretty good kick out of this level. Problem is, I don't visit all that often because, well, it's Axis. To be fair, if I really want to visit it over again, I'll just pick up a 3DS version and go on score attack.
That was a close call, but...
Actually saying that, half the reason why I like this level is because it comes straight after Axis.
Be careful, it might be a trap!
At that moment, this plane feels like a bloody jet plane. Slippy, really? You've only just noticed that things have been coming from the sea? Oh, wait. Oh, shit.
Disrespectful little whelp.
Pirate monkey?
I appreciate the respect.
Yeah, what have we got? We've got a ball and chain, we've got cannons, which give you an infinite supply of bombs. There's torpedo barrel cannons. And two exhaust pipes. And a motor. This is actually quite a unique little boss here. But basically, lasers don't actually do anything to this thing. You have to use bombs. That's why it's giving you an infinite supply with the cannons. You can shoot the, you can shoot the periscope with two bombs and then it gets destroyed. And as a result, now he has no idea where you are, so it's less likely for you to get hit. But he still fires anyway, because why the fuck not? Yeah, you can't actually do anything to him at the moment until you get rid of those exhaust pipes, because for some reason those exhaust pipes let him go underwater and retrieve any other part that you bomb off. Once you get rid of the exhaust pipes, then you can get rid of the cannons. Then he'll turn around to drop the crane behind him and try and pick it up, and then you can bomb the crane. Once you bomb the crane, he's defenseless. Then you just take down his one remaining cannon. And then you open up on him with lasers and dodge like hell. And that's pretty much it. It's quite a fun boss. Booyah. Well, that's it for Zonas.
All aircraft report.
Like I say, I'd say it's my third, possibly second favorite level in the game. Just because of the amount of stuff it's thrown at you.
Okay. Cat, where'd you go?
Anyway, I'll see you all later for the next part of Star Fox 64. See you guys there.